I'm not concerned about the very poor. We have a safety net there. If it needs repair, I'll fix it. I'm not concerned about the very poor. We have a safety net there. If it needs repair, I'll fix it. I'm not concerned about the very poor. We have a safety net there. If it needs repair, I'll fix it.
You didn't build that. Somebody else made that happen. You didn't build that.
I'm not concerned about the very poor. We have a safety net there. If it needs repair, I'll fix it.
On your own, I'm always struck by people who think, well, it must be because I was just so smart. There are a lot of smart people out there.
Which passages of Scripture should guide our public policy? Should we go with Leviticus, which suggests slavery is okay? Or we could go with Deuteronomy, which suggests stoning your child if he strays from the faith? Or should we just stick to the Sermon on the Mount, a passage that is so radical that it's doubtful that our own defense department would survive its application?
I like being able to fire people who provide services to me.
Corporations are people, my friend. We can raise taxes on... Of course they are. Everything corporations earn ultimately goes to people. So... Corporations are people, my friend. We can raise taxes on... Of course they are. Everything corporations earn ultimately goes to people. So...
I'm not concerned about the very poor. We have a safety net there. If it needs repair, I'll fix it.
Corporations are people, my friend. We can raise taxes on... Of course they are. Everything corporations earn ultimately goes to people. So...
You didn't build that.
I'm not concerned about the very poor. We have a safety net there. If it needs repair, I'll fix it.
Freedom of choice, as presidential candidate Ron Paul, shouldn't just be restricted to choices he approves of. He opposes things like prostitution and drug use, but says the federal government has no business trying to stop adults from doing them.
You would legalize marijuana, cocaine, heroin?
I would get the government out of regulating all those substances, and I would allow the states to deal with problems, whether children should have them, whether children can buy cigarettes and alcohol or hard drugs, marijuana, and different states would probably do different things. The first federal law against marijuana was 1938, and they did it through high taxation because they knew they didn't have authority to say that you're not allowed to smoke marijuana. Today, it's gone berserk. The federal government comes in and overrules a state that has legalized marijuana to be used for very sick people, AIDS and cancer, and they're getting some help. The federal government comes in, puts people in prison that are sick because they're using it for medical reasons, and they've never committed a violent crime. That's how absurd the war on drugs has become.
Alcohol prohibition led to more crime. You argue that even heroin could be legal if some state decided, wouldn't?
I think under our system of government that would be the case. But if you ask the people who are against it, if a state did that, would you use it? They say, oh no, I wouldn't use it. It's always those other people that might use it, so I have to take care of them and prevent them from doing harm to themselves.
What about that? Is that a role for government?
No, I don't believe so. I think the government's role should not be involved in personal habits. I believe those rules should protect children who are below the age of making good judgment. So I have no problem with state laws that would protect children from the use of these drugs. But under the Constitution, the president and the federal government wouldn't have a say in it.
Homosexuality. Should gays be allowed to marry?
Sure.
The state says we believe in this?
Sure, they can do whatever they want. They can call it whatever they want, just so they don't expect to impose their relationship on somebody else. They can't make me personally accept what they do, but they can, gay couples can do whatever they want. Matter of fact, I'd like to see all governments out of the marriage question. I don't think it's a state function. I think it's a religious function. And that there was a time when only churches dealt with, you know, marriage, and they determined what it was. But 100 years or so ago, for health reasons, they claimed that the state would protect us if we knew more about our spouses and we did health testing, and you had to get a license to get married. And I don't agree with that.
Prostitution.
I think when you defend freedom, you defend freedom of choice, and you can't be picking and choosing how people use those freedoms. So if they do things that you don't like and you might find morally repugnant, I, as an individual, I don't make that judgment. So I don't believe government can legislate virtue. I can reject it personally and preach against it, whether it's drugs or prostitution, but my solution comes from my personal behavior with myself and how I raise my children. But whether it's personal behavior or economic behavior, I want people to have freedom of choice.
Adults, you seem to be saying, own their own bodies. And if a woman wants to rent hers out, that's her business. If she wants or he wants to smoke crack.
Yeah, I think it's tragic. And matter of fact, I think the war on drugs, which has caused the price of drugs to go up, and we treat them as criminals rather than sick people, we have pushed a lot of people into prostitution. So prostitution is related to the mistakes we've made in the drug war. But you know, I think people, you know, make bad choices in religion and philosophy, but we don't regulate their thinking or their religious beliefs that they're not harming other people. That's why I defend this position that individuals should protect themselves. Governments can't protect individuals from themselves. It's just impossible. Otherwise, they become a tyrannical state.